It's that time of year again when wild fruits are ripe and ready to be picked. I didn't grow a garden this year, but the wild plants are very productive. Today I'm going to harvest one of my favorite wild fruits, the prickly pear. This burden basket is what I'm going to use to transport the harvest back to the hut. Then I will show you how I process the fruit for long-term preservation. It is obvious and very evident that this process for preserving prickly pear fruit is very slow and tedious, but it is important to remember that in primitive cultures, most of the work is slow and tedious. But these tasks are an important part of survival. It is possible to just simply dry the whole fruit in the sun and then store it in containers, but that leaves a rather undesirable food. Furthermore, the seeds need to be ground into a finer meal that can safely be eaten because the whole seeds cannot be digested. If properly stored in containers, this dry prickly pear candy will last for several years. There are many other wild foods that I am preserving for future use. Strips of fresh meat can be dried in the sun in just one day. Jojoba nuts are a tasty food that can be eaten in small quantities and also used in skincare. Holly leaf cherry seeds can be leached and ground into a tasty flour and stored as well. Manzanita berries can also be stored for years and add a delightful fruity flavor to other foods. Acorns are starting to ripen now and were once a major food source for native cultures. And this prickly pear candy is a tasty treat that I will enjoy through the winter. The texture is chewy like taffy, and it has a very rich tart flavor that my taste buds love. The prickly pear season will end in about a month, so I want to harvest a lot more and preserve it just like I did with the fruit in this video.